Hello and welcome to another episode of the Theater Professor Vidcast. While you're looking at this video, you'll see my setup is a little different. Well, there's a couple reasons for that. In the past, I've been using trial versions of Camtasia Studio, which, though a wonderful program, is currently a little out of my price range. And so I'm unable to purchase that. Maybe in the future, if I am able to garner some wages from doing these tutorials, fabulous, but I'm not counting on it. So I'm trying a different way. I'm using a free program called Open Broadcast Software. Cool thing about it is it lets me do all these nifty things. You see straight above me is the theater professor, and then over to this side is my screen. So it's kind of cool in that sense, but this is the first time I'm using it in this manner, recording. I usually use it to stream my video gaming, because I video game and I stream it. So we'll have to see how it does. Bear with me as we go through this, because I don't know how good this is going to work. Who knows? The sound might be better. The sound might be worse. The video might be better. The video might be worse. I might fall over and die because of how amazing it is. I just don't know. Also, it's daytime, so if you hear a little bit of sounds, it's probably outside, people being loud. My eyes are more than likely going to be down here looking at the screen, so you see my pretty face? Well, it's going to focus on this. Last week, we went through several of these tools, and this week we're going to finish up our tools. And for those that don't know, and if you weren't paying attention, this is iPad for the Artrage. Let's try that again. This is Artrage for the iPad. Man, I'm already off to a good start. All right, let's see here. The last three tools we have are Airbrush, Watercolor, and the Oil Painting, which I'm going to get into the palette knife too, but Oil Painting and palette knife kind of go together. And the palette knife can be used for other things such as blending. I've been using the desktop version of Artrage fairly regularly. So, on that note, I'm glad I remember things. I'm going to be doing a live webcast webinar type thing next week. I don't have the specific date yet. I'm checking on some calendar things real quick. Keep an eye on the website. I'm going to be doing it using actually this program, which streams really well, and it's going to be on Google. It's going to be Google Live, and you guys are going to be able to chit-chat with me as I give you my first tutorial on Artrage for the desktop. Not the iPad, but the desktop. So I'm doing something a little different here. I'm actually really kind of excited about this. So let's look at the Artrage for the iPad, shall we? I want to start with watercolor. Watercolor is my love in natural media. And I'm going to click it. There we go. And we have it available now. And let's pick a color just so we're ready. And let's click our little gears down here. And let's look at some of the settings that we have for watercolor. We have size. We have pressure. Thinners. Loading. Color bleed. And then you've got some checks. You can either have the paper wet or dry. You can have your watercolor insta-dry or stay wet. And you can have it auto-clean. Right now, we're going to click everything off. I'm going to bring the size up. Take everything else down. And we're going to bring pressure. We'll take pressure up to 100% to begin. So let's see what it looks like. So we lay down our first line. Ooh. Oh, that's right. Look at that. So I'm actually trying to pull farther, but you notice it is stopping. Well, that's because of the loading attribute, which I'm going to leave pressure up. I'm going to bring loading all the way to the top. And now when I go, it stays continuous. If I go back in there and take loading down about halfway, see, it's as if the watercolor is running out on the brush, just like the real thing. Okay. Hey, look, a Facebook message. Okay, let's go back into the settings. This is going to be an exciting one today. If we go back into the settings, and let's keep loading up all the way for now so you can see, and let's go to thinners and take thinners all the way up. Nothing's happening. I'm putting stuff down here. So I'm going to keep hitting that today. Let's take thinners to about 50. That doesn't do too much there. Let's do this. Let's clear the screen. Everybody remember how to do that? Clear layer. So this is with thinner at 50. Oh, I hit two button too many times. This is thinner at about 77. It's as if you've got more water on it. And thinner, we can't go to 100 because that means it's just water. So we'll go to like, 99 is probably too much. Let's go 92. And you can see how thin that gets, okay? Then we can even mix it with the thicker ones. Just a note, I did update to iOS 8. So what you're seeing here is iOS 8. I don't know if Artrage is updated or it needed to do any updates for iOS 8. That's something I can check later on. We open this back up. Let's turn thinners back to about 50%, and let's go color bleed. Now I'm actually going to need two colors here. There's one. Okay, this is color bleed at 100%, and then let's go and take color bleed down. Actually, let me undo that. Let me do it over here. Interesting effect as I go over this in the same spot over and over again. Come over here. Oh, the red didn't even bleed in. There we go. Okay. So it does some interesting effects. Would I say it perfectly mimics watercolors? No. But you have to understand, this is in and of itself an own art as well. So I wouldn't necessarily expect it always to mimic watercolor. I am losing battery life quickly. That means I'm going to need to plug in soon, which I'm going to have to pause when that happens. Pause. Like a dog. Pause. Okay. So it does have some settings, just like every... Oh, I forgot to do some of the other things. So right now, paper has not been wet the entire time. If we turn paper wet on, see how it's much more even? I'm just running over these. Okay, I almost never have paper wet. I hate that look. That's a personal preference. I do sometimes do Insta-Dry, and this is kind of cool. So with Insta-Dry, when you lay down your first, now let's lay down our second. It's like you're waiting for the watercolor to dry, and then you're putting another layer on it, which is how I like to do watercolors. I like layering things up one after another, and then if you grab a different color, you start to get different looks. Okay. And then again, you can be changing everything else while you're doing this. And then the auto clean, which I like the auto clean setup a little better on the desktop because you have a little water thing. But if I come in here and if I go over this, right? Notice how if I keep moving, it stays purple. Okay, and then I lift up and start a new one, back to blue. That's because I have auto clean on right now. If I turn it off, let me come down here. Come through here. Notice my color isn't back to the original. It's still the mix, okay? So if you have auto clean on, when you pick up and move to a different spot, you're going to get the original color. If you have it off, you keep the mixed color that you had created. So I'm gonna mix this a little more. And then if I come up here, see that? And then if I come over here, oops, if I come over here and mix in with this red again, And look at that, I get red. Okay, so that's the auto clean. It's an interesting feature. Now, there is a trick that I use with the watercolor on the desktop, which you can kind of use here, and that's to create different layers. And so what I'll do maybe is I'll take, I'm gonna turn auto clean on for now.
There we go, menu.
Okay. So say you want to do a color, but you don't want to, your next layer, you don't want to mess up what you have here. So we have a nice, you know, a nice square, rectangle. I'll go into the second level, layer, switch it to multiply. I can't even talk today. Switch it to multiply. Get a different color. And come over top of it like this. So now I'm not messing up what's underneath. It's just like if you let your watercolor dry and then you come over top of it to paint. You can kind of get this effect with the Insta-Dry too, but I always like the multiple layers and multiply. I just feel like it turns out niftier. Nifty. Because bow ties are cool. Don't you forget that. Oh my gosh, I watched last night one of my favorite episodes of Doctor Who, okay, is The Girl Who Waited. It's easily one of the best episodes of all of them. And it's because he saves her, but he doesn't save her, and then she dies. It's very sad. So let's look at some of the presets available to us. First off, we have Delicate on Dry. Let me clear these layers. This is Delicate on Dry. First, I'll show you if... Let me increase the size. There we go. This is with the stylus down the entire time. If I then lift up and start a new section and run into it, it just blends right into it. Okay, if we look at our settings right now, you can see that our pressure is about 50, our thinners are roughly at 63, loading at 100, and color bleed at 50. With auto clean on, we bring in our blue, and it goes into it. Get some really nifty effects here. Okay. Next, if we go to our second setting, which is dried strokes. Again, I want to increase the size. This is, see how we're layering on top there? It's really quite nice. Whoa! All right. And then you can even layer on top of what you already have down, as you can see here. And you can continue to layer if you want. So if you go over multiple times, it becomes less transparent and more opaque. Our next setting is dry on wet, which I don't really like. Hey, look, another Facebook comment. Okay, and then if I lift up and come down again, it just blends right into it. Not my favorite. I don't usually use it. The next setting is edible, because it just doesn't want to open. There we go. Maybe not. I've broken my iPad. No, literally, I have. Wow, it hates me right now. Okay, that opened. There we go. Harsh lines. Now, harsh lines does blend in a little bit, so you can see it there. Let's grab a second color. Let's Let's go yellow. It does create some, look at that mixing. I really like that mixing there. It is on auto clean now, as you can see, because even though I'm mixing in here, when I pull out, I'm getting the original color again. Okay. That's not bad. It's you know, it's not great. Harsh lines. Eh. Heavy bleed. Let me clear this. We've got so much junk up here. Junk up here. Clear layer. Notice how, okay, so the thickness of my line is only that thick, but when I come through here, you see the bleed, and then it goes back to its original. So that's the bleed. It's bleeding on the left and the right, well, kind of at a diagonal left and right. So that's heavy bleed. Just a spot is exactly that. Like, literally, I'm moving my stylus over the entire iPad, and all I'm doing is creating spots. Just water tries to mimic just water. So it's almost a way to start to erase. So if I pick up my stylus a couple times, you can see how I'm starting to erase that? That's picking up my stylus each time. So if you wanted to remove some things or create some, you know, some nifty effects, you start to do that. We have low blending. Look at that. When I went through the yellow, it didn't blend at all. So I'll do it again. So I'm going to start right here. See it? Yeah. And boom. Oh, that time it did blend a little bit, but not that much. See how when I come out, I'm still very blue? So it's not blending into the yellow very much. Low blending. Kind of makes sense. Small strokes on wet. That's interesting. Notice how it gets thinner as I go. Uh-oh, battery is dying. Clear layer. You have thin strokes on wet, which is very light, which means probably our loading is low. Let's look. See, our loading is only at 29%. It does bleed into each other, though. You're not, it's not insta-dry. We have unclean brush, which is exactly what it means. Let's increase. There we go. Whoa. There we go. So we've got that. Let's grab some green. And it takes the new color and makes it the main color. So it's a, you know, it's an unclean brush. Oh, that isn't. Notice how I keep that hideous color. Okay. I'm going to skip watercolor. That was a brush that I made. And then you have wet on wet. You see that? That was pretty cool, right? So let's do that again. I want to clear that layer. Let's go ahead and lay down a blue. Big old blue. And we're going to grab red. It's really kind of psychedelic. Now, one of the things you'll notice is it doesn't, one of the things the watercolor here doesn't do is it doesn't really create that sense of drippy, rough edges. On the desktop version, you can get it pretty darn close to it. It actually looks really good. But on the, why won't this disappear? There we go. On the iPad version, I found that it doesn't quite do what I want it to do. I wish it did, but it doesn't. Let's go ahead. I say a couple times today. Let's go ahead and clear my layer. Thank you. Clear my layer. There we go. So if you're trying to do like a true watercolor, it's going to take a little bit of practice to get exactly what you want. But one of the things you can do, and this is where I'm going to show you, I'm going to bring that up to 100, right? So I'm going to lay down, and I'm going to grab my palette knife. Right? And I'm going to pick what's called Hard Wet Blender. I'm going to increase the size a little bit. Now watch the edges. It starts to get closer to what it feels like when watercolor bleeds. And one of the things you can do is you can play with the settings on the palette knife, which we haven't gone deep into the palette knife yet. And you can, you know, you can try out all of these different settings to try and create what you want in regards to the edges of watercolor. Again, the desktop version, I feel, does this much, much better. The iPad version is okay, but the desktop version is really kind of awesome. And you can go in and you can go in and too far. Come on, come back to me. Change the settings, and there's a lot of different settings. Let's do this. Let's see what happens. Here. Well, that's almost like a straight blur, which there is a blur setting in there. Let's switch to this. This is wet. And you can change, like, you can literally change all of these settings. I mean, look at that. There we go. Now we're starting to get closer to what the edge of a watercolor might look like. Closer, not there yet. But I haven't played with it as much on my iPad as I have on the desktop. A reminder, I'm going to be doing a live webinar in regards to the desktop. And you can get the desktop version for free. So my suggestion would be to grab that free version, and we can kind of play with it together, the desktop version. All right. I'm going to actually I'm realizing I need more time on these than I did on some of the other ones. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do the airbrush, because the airbrush is pretty easy, okay? And then I'm going to stop and do the oil paint next week. And actually, no, I'm going to do this for you. I'm going to do it this weekend and put it up on Tuesday. So you're going to get an extra cast next week. Okay, so let's look at the airbrush. Several settings that are available: size, your blend mode, your pressure, tilt angle. Whoa! Let's decline that. I'll get to that in a second. Taper length, opacity, and auto flow. All right. Right now, I'm going to pause this recording and I'll be right back. All right, with that taken care of, let's go ahead and finish up the airbrush. As I was saying, you have size, you have your blend mode, which, you know, I'm not going to go through all of these. This is something for you to play with. You have pressure, tilt angle, taper length, opacity, and auto flow. We're going to turn everything down except for pressure and size. Let's see what we get. I get absolutely nothing right now. I'm loving it. I swear to goodness gracious. There we go. Oh, looks like we don't get anything with that. So let's see what we need. I am getting nothing with that. So let's turn, because I turned opacity down. Let's turn opacity all the way up. Okay. And again, that's with our pressure at 50. What if we had pressure at 100? It's a little darker. You can see it. It's not uber noticeable, but let's go pressure down to like 9%. And you can see there. Now you can really see the difference, okay? So we're going to go back to pressure. We'll reset this. There we go. And let's bring tilt angle up to 100%. Now that's kind of cool. It's as if you're tilting it like right up against the edge of the paper. It'd be great. Oh, what blend mode are we on right now? Are we at normal? Oh, but we're at 50% pressure. That's why. Okay. So let's take tilt angle down and take taper length up and see what happens. Not quite as noticeable right now. I guess if I go really fast, we kind of see it. Let's go ahead and take that taper length down to like right there. This is at 3%. Oh, so the low, that's kind of cool. As you can see, I don't use the airbrush really all that often. This is kind of new to me. And then auto flow. We got to clear this again. Whoa. Okay, so essentially what that does is you run out of air if you turn on auto flow. If I don't turn on auto flow. Oh no, that's the taper doing that. What do I got the taper set at? Taper length at 100. Set it down to 50. So that's something to be aware of, is that the longer you hold it down. Interesting. See, for anybody that is an actual airbrushist, if that's a term, you there, you airbrushist. Very good. Would love to hear your thoughts on this, if it acts or reacts like an actual airbrush. Airbrush is just I don't want to transform layer. Oh, and there. And now you get to see my texts. We're going to clear this layer. Now, this is with auto flow on. So it kept going. Do you see that? It never actually tapered down. If I turn the auto flow off. Oh, no, it didn't do it that time. Oh, yeah, it is. It's just very slow. Okay. So that's kind of fun. This airbrush, I'm going to have to sit and play with this more often, because this was like a blast. You know, I remember growing up, you'd see the airbrush people at the mall. There we go. There we got a nice taper. Bam! Tapered! Don't judge. Now what if, so let's see what happens when we change colors. Blend it. Okay, that doesn't really blend. Let's do this. I'm gonna take my taper length down. Yeah, it doesn't really blend. Definitely not. Not there at least. Oh, battery's almost dead. But if I go and do multiply, that's cool. Okay, that is pretty nifty. So if I did red and blue, we get a very, very dark purple. All right, so that's kind of the airbrush. I'm actually going to start playing with it in the future, using it for some skin tone stuff. That's always been on my mind. I've just never done it. So, I'm curious to see what other people think. Does it act like a real airbrush set? I've never done airbrush set. I've seen it done. I think it looks really cool, but it's just not something that I've ever done. All right. So, this has been a little longer on these two than I thought it was going to be, because these are pretty big tools. The watercolor and the oil paint. I'm going to go on and on about the oil paint, but you're getting an extra vidcast next week, so be happy about that. The oil paint and then the palette knife will allow you to do a lot of really cool things. Remember, this is what this is why I usually do my vidcasts my recordings at night, when people aren't texting me and emailing me and doing all sorts of things. I want to know your opinion on this setup. Do you like this setup better? Do you even care to see me at all? I'm pretty, I know. But I can change it back to where you don't see me at all. I think it's kind of nice being able to talk to you, but that's entirely up to you guys. I am going to be doing, if I end up doing this, I'm going to be doing some things with the setup so it looks a little cleaner. This was a very quick setup. I wanted to test it out, see if I could make it work. Also, don't forget, sign up at the website. In fact, if you're interested in doing the webinar that I'm going to do, free, remember, free webinar, and on top of that, I'm going to be able to answer your questions. That's kind of why I'm doing it. It's not only will I be able to show you in real time, but I'll be able to answer questions right there with you, which I think is really exciting, and let's see how it works. I could possibly fail miserably, but I got a good feeling. So sign up at the website, that's www.thetheaterprofessor.com, and sign up for our newsletter, because that's how I'm going to get the information out. I'm not going to, you know, I'll probably put it on the website as well, but you know, if you're part of the newsletter, then you'll get website information too. I know, it's crazy. So that's all I have for this week. I know this is coming a little late. I was not feeling up to snuff last night to get this done. Today I'm feeling much better. I wanted to get this finished for you guys. So Remember, my name is Terry Dana Jukimiak II, and I am the theater professor.